Have you ever stopped to think that it's possible to lose a lot of blood, like a lot of blood, and not die? Or is that just me? We can all live with about 2/3 of our blood lost. It's nuts. Let's break it down. On average, and this of course varies from person to person based on height and weight, an adult human has somewhere between 1.2 and 1.5 gallons of blood circulating in their body at any given time. And even though we say blood like it's one thing, blood is actually made of four things. Plasma is the liquid that carries salts, electrolytes, and blood cells around your body. Red blood cells are the ones that carry oxygen, white blood cells fight infection, and platelets help us stop bleeding when we get a cut. The interesting thing is that the parts that make up the blood don't have the same lifespan. Plasma is replenished as we eat and drink. Red blood cells last about 4 months, white blood cells turn over about every day, and platelets last about 10 days. And all those cells are made predominantly in the bone marrow, controlled by hormones. The takeaway here is that blood is always turning over. So say you donate a pint of blood, which is the standard amount and about 10% of your blood. The plasma will be replenished almost immediately, and the platelets and white blood cells pretty soon after because the body makes those all the time. But it takes days for a stem cell in the bone marrow to become a functional red blood cell, so it can take a few days or even a week for your body to replenish all the components of blood taken for that donation. And with red blood cells taking the longest to replenish while also having the vital function of carrying life-giving oxygen to all our organs, it's this cell count that doctors look at when you lose blood. I talked to my dad, Dr. Title, who is a hematologist, about what happens.
Red blood cells are needed to nourish all the cells in the body. They transport oxygen and release it to all the cells in the body. And red blood cells are not able to re-equilibrate as quickly. So if you bleed, the only blood cell that you're really going to see drop acutely is the red blood cells.
So how much blood can you lose before it becomes fatal? Well, Dr. Dad says it depends on how much you lose, but also how fast you lose it.
If you lose it quickly, then you are more likely to get into trouble because your blood volume is going to very quickly change and you're going to lose oxygen carrying capacity very quickly, and the body doesn't have any chance to adapt to that. If you lose it very slowly, for example, a slow leak from a bleeding ulcer or something, you can lose 2/3 of your blood volume probably and still, you may not feel very well, but you'll still be fully functional. If you lose that much blood from a gunshot wound or abruptly, you're going to collapse and you are going to need transfusion very quickly.
The important thing is hemoglobin.
We measure hemoglobin, for example, which is the blood pigment that makes blood red. We measure that in grams per liter. So if you drop your hemoglobin by, say, half of what it is to start with, you are likely going to need a blood transfusion if you lose that very quickly.
Basically, says Dr. Dad, your body can adapt to slow blood loss like it does to high altitude. So the same way you can't go from sea level to the top of Everest in one go, you can't drastically change your blood volume and survive. So it gets messy, literally. But at the end of the day, our bodies are sort of like a thermostat when it comes to blood. They're excellent at keeping everything on the right level so we can go on living. Thanks, body. And speaking of blood and adapting, sort of, we have a video about how snake venom isn't always bad right here. So what's your favorite blood fact? Let us know in the comments, be sure to like this video and subscribe for more Seeker.